In silico drug repurposing or repositioning is one of the fast-growing fields in computational drug discovery. The fundamental goal of drug repurposing is to find new disease that could be treated by known or in-trial drugs, which often have established information on safety, targets, and mechanisms of action from previous research. To find repurposing targets for a drug, one needs to find new connections between the target drug and diseases that are supported by data. Over the years, several computational approaches have been developed to discover such links. These methods can be classified based on how the links are defined into structural similarity-based approaches that screen for new drugs from candidates that are structurally similar to a known drug. Network-based methods that predict connections between drugs and diseases based on shared targets, pathways, disease phenotypes, drug indication, or side effects. And gene expression profile-based similarity, or connectivity mapping, that searches for drugs with gene expression profiles that are negatively correlated with disease-associated gene expression profile, with the assumption that a drug with reverse gene expression to that of disease could potentially relieve the disease by drive gene expression toward the normal state. In this module, we will focus on connectivity mapping-based drug repurposing. The concept of connectivity mapping between a drug and a disease was first introduced as the Connectivity Map or CMap platform, encompassing more than 7,000 microarray-based gene expression profiles from 1,309 FDA-approved drugs. The similarity or connectivity between a disease-derived gene expression signature and a drug-derived signature is calculated by Kolmogorov-Smirnov statistic-like algorithm. Here, genes in the reference set need to be ranked based on their differential expression compared to the control in the order starting from the most upregulated genes to the most downregulated genes. However, the genes in the query set do not have to be ordered. The connectivity score is calculated by comparing the query set against a reference set, and a positive connectivity score is given if the upregulated genes in the query set are near the top of the reference set and the downregulated genes in the query set are near the bottom of the reference set and vice versa for negative connectivity score. Such process is repeated for each reference set to get a connectivity score for each drug in the database with the query disease, and then they are ranked based accordingly. Those drugs at the bottom are then considered as potential therapeutics for the disease since they could potentially revert the disease gene expression profile back to its normal state. The CMap project rapidly gained popularity among the drug discovery community. CMap has, for example, facilitated the repurposing of anthelmintic drug parbendazole as an osteoclast differentiation inducer. In a more systematic study, 164 CMap drugs were matched against 100 different diseases, yielding more than 1,000 drug disease repurposing pairs, and two of these passed experimental validation. Despite its success, the potential impact on drug repurposing research of original CMap is inevitably limited due to its narrow small molecule and cell line coverage. There are only 164 drugs in three cancer cell lines in the CMap database. Thus, a new platform for drug disease connectivity mapping was developed, utilizing the L1000 high-throughput platform, as the successor of the CMap platform. The new connectivity map platform holds more than a million L1000 profiles covering more than 2,800 small molecules in more than 72 cell lines. It provides integrated access to datasets, results from the processing and analysis of Pertabagan data, and software tools. The data and tools are freely available to academic users,